I'd just like to kneel for a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we give thanks for all the blessings that we receive during the night season, and thank you for a new day. And thank you, Lord, for blessing us that we can come to gather this morning. We pray your Holy Spirit will be with us and help us, and that the Holy Angel will protect us as we share your word. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 And this morning, we're going to continue studying in the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 58, the health message in this chapter of Isaiah 58. And we're going to continue studying. Last Sabbath, we start studying, and I put a foundation for this chapter. And after I study preventive healthcare back in 1991 in California, studying histology, anatomy, and physiology, I come to understand how important it is for us to know how our organs of the body work, and especially the brain. Do you know why? Because it is the brain where we will receive the seal. It's the place where we receive the seal of God. Amen. Revelation chapter 22 verse 4 says that God will put his name in our heart, the seal of God. We will receive it in the frontal lobe, and therefore it is important for us to understand how the brain works, the anatomy, the histology, anatomy and physiology of the brain, reason, conscience, and will. And Satan is working in all his ways with knowledge and science to confuse the brain.
Yes.
To confuse, to bring confusion. And therefore, Babylon is confusion. And do you know, working back and forth in United States, Europe, South America, the big problem of health today, of the people today, is with the brain. Do you know, and even doctors, it is very difficult for doctors, for specialists who have been studied to help people that have mental problem. It is more easy for a surgeon to make surgery on the heart of a people who have problem with the heart. And the heart is just this pump that pumps the blood through the body. It's not the brain. Is there some problem with the heart? The surgeon can just take out the heart, fix it, and put it back in. But working with people who are confused, it is difficult for human beings. It is only God and the Holy Spirit can help people who are confused to receive healing. Confusion. And what is confusion? The word confusion. If we see the word confusion, it says mentally unclear, or uncertain, that is confusion. And studying histology, anatomy, and physiology of the brain, you know, Satan work on the chemical level to bring confusion in the brain. And we have to be careful. Therefore, God give us his principles, his law. He give us a pattern. He gives us a design. And especially for Israel, God gave Israel a design, a pattern to follow. And in Leviticus 19:19, God is giving us instructions and principles and laws. And he says, don't mingle seeds. Because it will bring confusion. And if you study agriculture, the A, B, and C of education, in agriculture, you see how Satan is work to change the especially the food that we eat, the vegetables, with other words, the nutrients that the brain need to function properly, he bring there confusion. So that it can confuse the brain. You see? He work on chemical level. He work with our senses. He work through our vision. He work through our ear, our touch. So that his goal is to reach the brain, the frontal lobe. Yes. And we have to be aware of this. And we have to pray that God will protect us, that we will not permit Satan to go through all this science to reach the brain, to reach the frontal lobe and confuse the brain. And confuse us. And with other words, it says also, confusion is to mix up things. And when we mix up seeds, we bring confusion, especially what the brain need to function, the nutrition of the brain. And therefore, we have to study the Word of God, especially Isaiah 58, because there is promise in Isaiah 58 for his people today. The same sins of Israel in the past is the same sins today. And therefore, Isaiah is warning us not to transgress the laws of God. And God gives Sister White a lot of instructions for us today that are living in these last days. And in the book of Ministry of Healing, page 183 to 184, it says God's plan for Israel. We need to know God's plan for Israel. In God's plan for Israel, every family had a home on the land with sufficient ground for tilling. Thus were provided both the means and the incentive for a useful industry. And it says both the means and the incentive for the useful industry and a self-supporting life. And no devising of man has ever improved upon that plan. To the world departure from it is owing to the large degree of poverty and wretchedness that exists today. In God's original plan, every family had a home on the land with sufficient land to cultivate, to care for what was necessary for the home, for the food. And it is through the food, the nutrition, today that Satan is working through the body, through the blood, to reach the brain and to confuse the brain. Just as you work in the natural world, in the agricultural world, so he works also in the spiritual world to mix up seed, he mixed up God's seed with the seed of the enemy. Then he mixed up seed. Then this will bring confusion, because people cannot see the difference about of a seed that is not a GMO seed or a seed that is organic.
Yes.
People today cannot separate truth from error. Today, many gospels has been preached all over the world, and especially those who have come out of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, a corporate church, because of the Trinity doctrine, that is confusion.
That's right.
But if you study and you visit most of the groups of all these brothers and sisters that come out of the Seventh-day Adventist Church because of Trinity, most of them still are in confusion.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Because if we don't study, if we don't pray and depend on God's Holy Spirit to help us to separate truth from error, we will be, yes, we will be continue eating GMO seed. And GMO seeds is confusion. Jesus says in John 8:32, you should know the truth and the truth will set you free. It is only the truth that can set us free. And all seeds that are GMOs bring confusion. It confuses the plant world. It confuses the fruit that come from a GMO seed. It is confusion. And those who use these fruits and vegetables and beans, it work on their body to confuse the brain. We have a question.
When you said truth, it made me think of the end time. We have to be grounded in the truth.
Mm-hmm.
If we can't know the truth in the end time, then we're lost.
Amen. Brother says that we need to know the truth from this end time. If we don't know the truth, we are in problems. It is only the truth that can root out the confusion in the heart of man. And the message has to be pure. The message has to be with no GMO seeds, no confusion. For example, sometimes I give some testimony for you to understand how serious this is. Back some years ago, we went down to Brazil, I and Pastor Allen. And we were sharing there in Brazil. And there in Brazil, there is a problem, big problem. There is two groups. One believe that Jesus is God, and the other one believe that Jesus is the representative of God. And Pastor Allen was presenting the truth, presenting the organic seed, but the other person, a leader there, was presenting that Jesus is a representative of God. And there was a big group, and I was translating from Spanish, from English to Portuguese, and Portuguese to English. And I can see that Pastor Allen was presenting the organic seed, the truth, but this person was presenting a GMO seed. And the people was confused. And some of the people in the congregation says, we cannot see the difference of Pastor Allen's message and this brother message. They can see the difference. They say that it is the same thing that they are presenting. But it was not the same thing. One was GMO seed and the other was organic seed. Truth mingling with error. And it is not easy for people to see this. It is only by the working of the Holy Spirit that can help us to separate truth from error. And therefore, in this book of Isaiah, it is not only health, the physical health, eating and drinking, but it is complete. It is the whole package that God gave, the whole plan for Israel, so that we can understand the truth, that it is only the truth that can make us free. Isaiah 58, book of Isaiah 58.
My Bible says it's about fasting.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Isaiah 58, Sister White gave a lot of commentary on this chapter in Manuscript 28, 1900.
What manuscript again?
Manuscript 28. 1900. And one of the parts that's very important, she says, when this is done, this work is done, there will be an increase of moral sources and the church will no more remain almost stationary. Moral sources. Moral agriculture, immoral agriculture. Moral agriculture is those who use organic seeds. Because if you don't use organic seed, you need GMO seeds, you will see that after a time, your soil will be destroyed. And you have to move to look for other places to continue with your GMO seeds, because the GMO seeds destroy the ground.
Wow.
So my brothers and sisters, preventive health care is the work to prevent, is the work to help our brothers and sisters not to use GMO seeds, not to mingle seeds, not to mingle truth with error, because it will bring confusion and destruction. In our work, we shall find a high profession of piety and much outward exactness bound up with great inward wickedness. Ministers of God have been guilty of the sin of disregarding, and thus said the Lord, they have led the member of their churches to observe rites which have no foundation in the word of God, but are in direct opposition to his law. And therefore, Isaiah 58 verse 1 says, cry loud, spare not. Cry loud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins.
Amen.
And you know, when you study chapters 58 of Isaiah, what other chapter you remember in the Bible that give the same words that we have to cry loud? Remember Revelation chapter 18? A loud cry. Call people to come out of Babylon, because Babylon is confusion. Babylon is the mix-up of things, you know? As his wife says, continue saying, in the book Letters 76, 1902, the only cause of safety, my brethren, you need to study more carefully the 58th chapter of Isaiah. This chapter marks out the only course that we can follow with safety. The prophet receives this word from the Lord, a message startling in its clearness and force. Cry loud, spare not, Lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins. Though they are calling the people of God, the house of Jacob, though they profess to be linked with God in obedience and fellowship, they are far from Him. Wonderful privileges and promises have been given to them, but they have betrayed their trust. With no words of flattery must the message be given them. Show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sin. Show them where they are making a mistake.
That goes for us today.
Mm-hmm. The same sin of Israel in the past is the same sin of Israel today. Amen. And God is calling His people. They had nothing except that which they had received from God. He bestowed His goods on them that they might be His helping hands, doing what Christ would do were He in their place, giving a true representation of the principles of heaven. This is Isaiah 58, and a lot of quotations that help us to understand sin of Israel or sin today. Sin of Israel in the past or sin of Israel today. A reformatory influence from God needed in our time. The people here described realize that they have not the favor of God, but instead of seeking His favor in His own way, they enter into controversy with God. They ask why, since they observe so many ceremonies, the Lord does not give them special recognition. God answered their complaints. Behold, in the day of your fast, ye find pleasure and accept all your labors. Behold, ye fast for strife and debate, and to smite with the fist of wickedness. Christians, not a band of mourners. We have everything to be thankful for. Mm-hmm. Never ought Christians to move along like a band of mourners in a funeral train. God does not require this of His followers. He does not ask them to spread sackcloth on and ashes under them. Is it such a fast that I have chosen? He asks, a day for a man to afflict his soul? Is it to bow down his head as a brewer's and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him? Will thou call this a fast? Will you call this a fast? An acceptable day of the Lord? God tells us what kind of fast He has chosen. Is not this the fast that I have chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness? To undo the heavy burdens? And to let the oppressed go free? And that ye break every yoke? This is the fast He wishes us to observe. Amen. As we follow in the path of self-denial and self-sacrifice, helping the needy and suffering, we shall lay up treasures before the throne of God. Amen. And Isaiah is telling us that today, around us, there is people who are hungry and afflicted. Isaiah 58, verse 10 says, and if thou draw all thy soul to the hungry and satisfy the afflicted soul, then shall thy light rise in obscurity, and thy darkness be as the noonday.
Wow. Amen.
You know, all over the world today, people, and there's a lot of people that is hungry. They don't have food.
Or water.
Of water.
Clean water.
Clean water. And back in Curacao, we can, you know, see some years ago, we heard by the news that in Africa, people were suffering. No food, no water. But these last years in Curacao, where I live, Curacao is just 60 miles north of Venezuela. And when we have clear weather where I live, I can see the mountains and the hills of Venezuela. And today, people in Venezuela are hungry. They don't have food. You know, from Venezuela, they just move in small boats, you know, to come over to Curacao, illegal, to find food in Curacao. It is terrible. And we can see these things. We can see how small boats come. They just move from Venezuela in the night to reach to Curacao. And sometimes they put 30 person in a small boat that can carry only 10 person. And sometimes the boat just flipped and all these people die in the sea.
Venezuela also has a tremendous resource in oil,
mm-hmm.
but it's been corrupted.
Exactly.
There's been corruption and the money has not gone to the people.
Mm-hmm. Brother Robert says that in Venezuela there is a lot of resources, a lot of oil, and because of the corruption, the money don't go to the people so that they can...
They're suffering.
The corruption, sin, transgressions of God, law, bring hunger and affliction. The people are hungry and afflicted. And, you know, it is terrible to see how in young people from Venezuela, nice young girls, wives, who the husband sent them from Venezuela to come to Curacao to do prostitution and to send food for the family back home. And I saw how they buy, you know, cornmeal, oil and thing, and send them to Venezuela for the family to eat. Husband just tell the wife, go and do prostitution and send food for us, otherwise we will die. Hungry and afflicted, and we can see these things today. And God is calling us to give these people food. Not only physical food, but very important, the spiritual food. The Word of God, the truth that we have to share with these people. And then, if we are doing this work, God says, then shall thy light rise in obscurity, and thy darkness be as noonday. Verse 11, and the Lord shall guide thee continually, and satisfy thy soul in joy, and make fat thy bones, and thou shalt be like a watered garden, and like a spring of water, whose waters fail not. Verse 12. And they that shall be of thee shall build the old waste places. Thou shalt raise up the foundation of many generations, and thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of path to dwell in.
Those are the blessings that Yahweh has promised us.
Yahweh is promising, sure. And so I give commentary on verse 12 and 14. We will find this commentary in letter 1F1890. Sabbath keepers, repairer of the breach. Where do we find the people who are thus addressed? Who is it that shall build the old waste places and raise up the foundation of many generations? You make the question. Where are the people who have had light from heaven to see that a breach has been made in the law of God? And the revelation of John says, the temple of God was open in heaven, and there was seen in the temple the ark of his testament. Revelation 11, 19. John saw in vision the Lord's people looking for his coming and searching for truth. As the temple of God was opened into his people, the light of the law of God, which was in the ark, shone forth. Those who receive this light are brought to view in the proclamation of the third angel message. This angel is flying in the midst of heaven, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that kept the commandment of God and the faith of Jesus. This is the people that are repairing the breach in the law of God. They see that the Sabbath of the fourth commandment has been supplanted by a spurious Sabbath, a day that has no sanction in the word of God. Amid great opposition, they become loyal to their God and take their position under the standard of the third angel. This we find in manuscript 48:1900. Letters 1890 says, as the end approach, the testimony of God's servant will be more decided and more powerful, flashing the light of truth upon the system of error and oppression that have so long held the supremacy. The Lord has sent us message for this time to establish Christianity upon an eternal basis. And all who believe present truth must stand, not in their own wisdom, but in God, and raise up the foundation of many generations. These will be registered in the book of heaven as a repairer of the breach, the restorer of paths to dwell in. We are to maintain the truth because it is truth. In the face of the bitterest opposition, God is at work upon human minds. It is not man alone that is working. The great illuminating power is from Christ. The brightness of his example is to be kept before the people in every discourse. Hold man to stand in the gap. Who will stand today in the gap? Hold man will stand in the gap. I write this because many in the church are representing to me as seeing men like trees walking, she says. Many as trees walking. They must have another and deeper experience before they discern the snare spread to take them in the net of the deceiver. There must be no halfway work done now. The Lord called for stench, decided whole-souled man and woman to stand in the gap and make up the hatch. Isaiah 58:12-14. There is a decided testimony to be borne by all our ministers in all our churches. God has permitted apostasy to take place in order to show how little dependence can be placed in men. Is not there apostasy today in the churches? Are the people dependent today on their pastors, their leaders? Instead of dependent on Jesus? We are always to look to God. His word is not yea and nay, but yea and amen. We have to fix our eyes on Jesus, not on man. We have to be sure that we use organic seed, that we study the Word of God, that God will help us to separate mingling seed from organic seeds. To use organic seeds means that our fruits that we will have on our table to eat will have all the minerals and the salt that make the fruit sweet. If you eat this fruit, it's not sweet because the mineral and salt is not there. The soil has been depleted from its nutrients, and also because it is organic seed, you don't smell if you are eating a fruit that have to give smell when you eat it. Like organic seeds, when you eat the fruit or when you just smell, you will smell the fruit.
Smell the difference.
The difference. You will, when you eat it, you will receive all the nutrients that the body need to go in the body, in the heart, in the blood, and to circulate in the brain, not to confuse the brain, but to give the brain the energy to think properly and to take decision and to not to be confused, because God is not a God of confusion. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 33. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 33. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 33. Our frontal lobe, where we have to be sealed, there must be there no confusion, because God is not a God of confusion. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 33 said, "For God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints." If people are confused, if people are depressed, if people are suffering of depression, it is a hard work to help people in our own strength. It is only by God's grace and mercy, only through the truth, only receiving the pure word of God, that confusion can be taken away from the brain, from the heart. No surgeon can make a work on the brain and to take out confusion. They can take out the heart, fix the heart and put it in. But they cannot take the brain and take out confusion and put it back. It is only the work of God, Holy Spirit, of Jesus. No medication can do this. I have been helping many people who are depressed, who are confused. But it is God, it is the Holy Spirit, it is Jesus who can heal the heart. It is Jesus that can change the heart of stone to the heart of flesh. We can do that. We can be just a helping hand of God to help people, to use organic seeds, to do exercise, to drink water. But finally, it is Jesus Christ. Only Jesus can heal a brain, a heart that is confused, and give Him the peace of Jesus Christ. Sin is the transgressions of the law. And sin is compared as leprosy. Do you know in Matthew chapter 8 verse 3, I like to always, when I read a verse, I will go to Desires of Ages and, you know, try to study the scene and to see Jesus dealing with this leper who came to him. Do you know this leper was living outside because he cannot be in contact with people? And he was praying that one time when Jesus was walking, that Jesus will just came in a way that he can see him and he can come to him and to ask him to help him, to heal him of his leper. Leprosy was a terrible thing. Sin is a terrible thing. We can help people. We can take away sin of anybody. Only Jesus. But this leper, he saw Jesus was moving. Where he was far from Jesus, but still he could hear the voice of Jesus. And he can see how Jesus was touching people who were sick, the deaf. And his faith grew in him. And he started coming closer. And see how many people who were sick, Jesus was put in the hand and they have been healed. His faith grew. And he says, I'm a leper. But if I can go to Jesus, if I can reach Jesus, he can heal me. And his faith was strengthened as he saw, as he hear Jesus healing and preaching the word. And he made the decision. He was determined to go to Jesus. And he, when he was coming closer to Jesus, the people around Jesus saw him. And they cry, a leper. And they try to do everything that this leper will not come to Jesus Christ. But the leper, it says in Desire for Asian, he didn't hear nor see the people who was telling him, you are a leper, go from here. You are a leper, go from here. They tried to push him away. But it says that the leper didn't hear nor see these people. The only thing that he was fixing, focusing, was Jesus. To go to Jesus. If he can go to Jesus, he will be healed. And he make his way. No barrier, no obstacles. Only thing is to look to Jesus and to reach Jesus for healing. And today, we are as lepers. We are in a state, in a condition just as this leper. We need to focus on Jesus Christ. We have to do everything. Don't let any barrier, nor obstacles, not what people say about you. Make your way to find Jesus Christ. Because he alone can heal us. He alone can take away sin. And this leper, he was determined. And he reached Jesus. And Jesus healed him. And what a blessing. And today, we are living in the world, my brothers and sisters. Prophecies are fulfilling. And difficult time is before us. Many obstacles, many problems. But don't look to this problem, but fix your eyes on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And be determined to be with Jesus Christ when he comes back. May God bless us as we trust him and look to Jesus for help. Amen. I have a lot of notes on Isaiah 58. I will just leave them with Pastor Allen, and those who like a copy, he will make a copy for you, and you can have these materials. When you go home, you can continue study Isaiah 58 and also some material on GMOs, how you can prepare for what is coming. May God bless us.
Amen.
Shall we kneel down for a word of prayer? Our Heavenly Father, we give thanks for Jesus Christ, our Savior. And we thank you, Lord, for Isaiah chapter 58, the health message. We pray, Father, that you will help us to obey all the principles of health, to obey your laws, and to determine in our heart, Father, to be with Jesus when he comes back. Help us, Father, to override all obstacles, throw down all barriers, and plant the banner in the camp of the enemy. Bless us, Father, we pray as we move forward. In Jesus' name, amen.